The Energy Efficiency Power Plant is the second largest power resource in the Northwest. Like any system, it's most efficient when all of its components are working together. The energy savings that fuel this energy efficiency power plant come from many sources: utility programs, market transformation efforts, codes and standards, and cultural and market shifts all influence consumers' purchase decisions. Energy savings that aren't directly incentivized by utilities are called momentum savings. Momentum savings encompass all energy efficiency that happens outside of utility-funded programs in the Northwest. Momentum savings are big, really big. Projections show us momentum savings could account for as much as 30 to 50% of Northwest energy savings in 2015. We really can't afford to ignore momentum savings. Not only do they make up a substantial piece of the region's energy efficiency, they also help us understand the market and improve our programs. By learning where savings happen outside utility programs, we can better focus our work inside those programs. So where do we start? First, we need to know how to measure momentum savings. In order to do this, we must answer four questions. What is the market? How big is the market? What are the total market savings? And what are the program savings? No single product can give us a full picture of the efficiency of the market. In the residential lighting market, for instance, there are many different types of light bulbs, both efficient and inefficient, including halogen, incandescent, CFL, and LED. If you were to look only at CFL sales, which have been fairly flat since 2011, you might not think energy efficiency was improving in the market. But if you look at all light bulb sales, you'd see that incandescent sales fell, but LED and halogen sales grew. These nuances are important to recognize. Once we know which market we're measuring, we have to figure out how big that market is. To discover the true size of the market, we have to understand two key characteristics: product flow and stock turnover. Product flow is all of the new products sold and installed in the market. Stock is all of the currently installed products. Stock turnover is how the stock turns over, as older products wear out and new products are installed to replace them. We learn about product flow by analyzing national and regional sales data, plus additional shipment information from retailers and distributors. We learn about stock from regional building stock assessments. This allows us to estimate product flow and stock turnover to understand the size of the market we're measuring. Now, we know how big the market is, but we still need to determine what the total market savings are. Every 5 years, the Northwest Power and Conservation Council updates the Northwest Power Plan. At the same time, the council establishes how much energy is used in each important market in the region. To do this, the council develops an efficiency baseline for each market. This is generally based on recent product flow data and the average efficiency of products being sold in the market. This baseline provides a snapshot in time, which we use to measure changes in efficiency. Anything more efficient than the baseline represents a new efficiency resource. To determine total market savings, we calculate the energy use in the year the power plan was written and the energy use in following years. To calculate energy use in the years following the baseline, we look at the current mix of products using detailed sales data and other information from manufacturers and contractors to find out how much energy the total market consumes. Using the baseline as a starting point, we establish how each component of the market has changed and how our energy use has changed over time. This gives us total market savings. The final question we have to answer is, what are the program savings? Since momentum savings are savings that occur outside utility programs, we must clearly understand which savings come from utility programs. We do this by adding up the savings from direct utility incentives and retail programs, and then subtracting these from total market savings. What remains are momentum savings. To calculate the momentum savings in a market, remember, what is the market? How big is the market? What are the total market savings? And what are the program savings? By understanding the total savings in the market, not just utility program savings, we ensure the energy efficiency power plant runs optimally to help us meet the region's power needs. For more information, please visit BPA's Momentum Savings webpage.